Welcome to Car Scene Korea. The car I have behind me is E-GMP, which stands for Electric Global Modular Platform. That's one of the first electric modular platform that Hyundai has developed, and we have full prototype models displayed right here in Hyundai Motor Studios Seoul. So let's get into it. And this platform is not relatively a brand new technology, but this skateboard platform, so-called, has been witnessed throughout a lot of electric manufacturers, and of course that being Tesla. But Hyundai is one of the first manufacturers to come up with a modular platform solely for EV models. This platform, E-GMP, marks the very beginning of the technology. And this platform is the very basic, literally the platform of the platform. So on top of this modular platform sits the frames over there, which I will be, of course, touching in a couple of minutes. Running through some of the specs of this platform is that from the original 400 volts supported EV platforms, this is now capable of 800 volts, which is hooked up with high-speed charger, so-called high charger they call it. All of this platform and technology is rear-wheel based, and that of course is most suitable to make it into an all-wheel drive and four-wheel drive. The batteries will charge about 80% in first 18 minutes with the 800 volt high-speed charger, and there will be 500 kilometers maximum travel distance per charge. For the first 5 minutes, it is capable of charging 100 kilometers driving distance. So that's nearly about the time you spend in a gas station. And I personally think I spend way more than that. So for the 5 minutes, you can charge 100 kilometers driving distance. That will well cover a daily driver capacity for that matter. And this technology is patented by Hyundai, and the inverter type electric motor that's inside of this motor package right here enables the old 400 volt stations to boost up their voltage to 800. It's also capable of using the pre-existing charging stations into a high power speed that I just told you about. So that's something that Hyundai has gone above and beyond. And this is the main motor that will be used throughout along with that platform. So it's the E-GMP rear traction motor system. Let's take a quick look at what it looks like inside. And what's notable on this motor is the way they wrap the coils around. They call it its hairpin. And this technology alone ensures about 10% increase in its efficiency. Just this technology alone, that's quite smart and brilliant. Just look how they're wrapped around and coiled around the system right here. So let's take a look at this one right here, ICCU, which stands for Integrated Charging Control Unit. And this actually alone works like a battery pack. It's capable of using both 110/220 voltage. When it's charged, it could actually run a living room size of air conditioner and 55 inch television at the same time for, guess the number, full 24 hours. So right here, compared to that main motor right there, this is a smaller version. So take a look at this one right here. That cylinder is a bit shorter than this cylinder right here. So this is put on the front wheel. So it says front traction motor system. And what's really, really notable on this front motor is that for the first time in the world, Hyundai has integrated the disconnector that allows these two motors, when they're put together on the front and the back of the car, this can turn into a four-wheel drive. And that's possible with this motor right here because it has a disconnector that actually literally disconnects the motor to the car or from the car. So that is that feature right there with the bearings right there. These gears right here are filled up with fluids and oil lubricants, which will be spinning around, delivering the power to the car. Inside here, instead of a cylinder batteries that we've seen on Tesla and so forth, instead of those, Hyundai has picked up with a vertical type so that there is nearly no dead space. The space in this battery pack is therefore fully used. Put these boxes together, they will form the battery module. So depending on your need, depending on what kind of car you are building, put those modules together, put them in as many as you need or want, put it inside right here, then ta-da, you get a car of your choice or desire. You could get a regular sedan, stretch it out, put in more module. This will be a bigger sedan or a saloon for that matter, and make it shorter, make it more compact, get rid of the front motor and instead just use the rear wheel. Then you could have yourself a sport car for that matter. Once a sports car is made out of this module, it will be capable of doing 0 to 60 under 3.5 seconds. The top speed is currently at 260 kilometers per hour. This will deliver most of the needs for the sportiness. What's really notable for this suspension setup for E-GMP platform, it has 5 multi-link system for the rear wheel. There's one right here, 2, 3, and come over this way, 4, and 5. So literally multi-linked to wheels and the platform right here, or the chassis. With this platform, you get this outer structure. It's not even outer, still in inner structures, but compared to that one, it is an outer. So that on top of that module will come in this steel plus aluminum mixed platform that will sit on top of that module. And once that's happened, this is what it looks like from the front. The H-beam that will absorb the impact upon, should there be an accident, God forbid, but should there be an accident, that will serve and deliver the purpose and protect the passengers inside the car, as well as the center beam that's hooked up for more rigidness. And all throughout, you could see how much effort that Hyundai has put into the platform to keep not only the passengers, but as well as this part right here. So that's what on the Hyundai video they have highlighted in red, saying that they have emphasized on its increased strength. So these frames and structures right here on the outer part of the base frame will try its best to protect the batteries within the car. So right here are where all the batteries will be sitting, or right underneath this one, because this one is going on top of it. So the car is trying every effort to protect not only the passengers, but also as well as batteries. Compared to the front structure that we see that stretches out all the way up here, kind of trying its best to protect the passenger right behind, we don't have another set for the rear. But again, this being module, you know, you can always make necessary changes for that. And for the front motor sitting a little taller compared to the one on the back, I don't think there will be a Frunk for this car, but the researchers are said to be, they're still debating whether they want to, you know, they could still lower the engine and they could lower the motor anytime they want. And should there be a need or want, they can make a Frunk anytime they want, you know, just lower this one a little bit, make it more compact or so. So that we'll have to see. So one more thing I kind of want to tell you are, you see these outlets or little holes right there, the 8 points, that's a direct plug and play for this module, which we could see right here, or even so more visible from the bottom reflection. So those holes will be a direct plug and play. You could always stretch out this portion of the car according to the need. If you're building a bigger sedan, you just put in another pack of batteries and stretch this module out, you get a larger sedan. And of course, the other way, you want a shorter car, just shorten, you know, take out a row of cells, then you get a shorter car and you get a swift, fast driving, agile vehicle that you are looking for. And that being said, Hyundai is planning to make 23 EV models by the year 2025, and they are currently targeting to make 1 million units of EV car sales worldwide. And Hyundai currently is selling about 7 million cars worldwide, so that's one EV car sold per every 7 vehicles, all Hyundai sold. So we'll have to see about that, but we all know the future is the EV, and it's not even the future, it's right around the corner. And also, one big advantage for the skateboard platform is that the batteries all sit very low to the ground, so it has lower center of gravity, better for performance and driving and corners and all throughout all that. But a bit of downside for that is because of the batteries sitting right below, of course there will be another extra platform or the body shells on top of it, and then you start to throw in those seats for the passengers and drivers, so that makes the car and the roof to be a bit taller by that much. So for that reason, most of the EV cars that we see today on the roads are mostly looking like a CUV or like a fat sedan for that matter. So we'll have to see about what kind of ideas and technologies not only Hyundai but other manufacturers come up with for the sporty cars or sports cars for the EV models. All right, I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe and like, and I'll see you with other newly released Genesis, Hyundai, and Kia cars. Thanks for watching.